tumurang ato ang halangdong Senador Bongbong Marcos. Maayong Senator.
Welcome to the show,
Thank you very much for having me. Maraming salamat.
First question, what brought to the shores of Davao?
Well, meron lang ako speaking engagement and we have with the mining engineers, we saw them this morning. So I held some meetings with some of the businessmen. Tuloy-tuloy ang konsultasyon tungkol sa mga iba't ibang batas. So this is the legislative work.
Davao City, welcome to you.
Thank you very much.
So we want to ask you, what is your position or what's your take on federalism?
Federalism, I think, as a political theory, I think it is a very good one. Dahil una-una, ang sinasabi, pagka yung federalism, kinakalat mo ang power center.
Mm-hmm.
Ibig sabihin, maraming power center sa bawat state or province or region or whatever you want to call it. At kahit magka-problema sa isang lugar, hindi ibig sabihin babagsak lahat, magkakaproblema sa lahat. Nga pagka na the power is centered in Manila, kagaya na ngayon, pagka may problema sa Manila, yung buong bansa apektado.
Mm-hmm.
And besides that, may recognition na ang bawat lugar ay iba.
Mm-hmm.
These are all individual with their different needs, with their different concerns, with their different capabilities, assets, whatever. And so you have to treat each one differently, and the best people who can determine what is needed in a locality, in a community, yung mga tiga doon.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the basic theory behind that federalism. That's why I think it will be a good discussion, and I think it's about time we return to that, because nagsimula na tayo eh. Yung interim batas ng pambansa was regional.
Mm-hmm.
Regional ang representation. Pero hindi natuloy yun, so it's time, I think, to revisit the concept at kumutignan natin kung babagay dito sa, kung babagay para sa Pilipinas.
Kanina po, Senator, napag-usapan po namin about constitutional amendment.
Mm-hmm.
If ever there will be a chance na amendahan or baguhin ang ating konstitusyon, will you support the change of our form of government to federalism?
Oh yes, certainly. I think we really have to... First of all, in terms of in the constitutional amendments, I think they're necessary.
Mm-hmm.
There are many things that need to be again re-examined. Only not because the concept was wrong, but because the passage of time has changed things and the situation has changed, so we have to adjust accordingly. But I was listening earlier. I share the fear of the mayor that we do not know what will be taken up.
Mm-hmm.
Once the Constituent Assembly is called to order, any member of that Constituent Assembly can stand up and speak about any subject.
Mm-hmm.
So if they open a subject, wala ka na magagawa. It's already in session. So it's a question that really has to, if we can find safeguards, sabihin natin, meron tayo mahanap na paraan na pag-uusapan lang talaga ay economic provisions. Kung magagawa, mas maganda yun. But still, we don't have that yet. Kasi kung maaalala ninyo, yung batas para mag-amyenda ng walang enabling law, tinatawag. The Constituent Assembly is the body that will change that, but there is no enabling law. There's no rules pa. Wala pa tayong rules kung paano gagawin. At ang pinagdibatihan ng matagal, ng panahon ni GMA, is kung boboto ng sabay ang House at saka yung Senado.
Uh-huh.
Siyempre, yung Senado gustong kaiwalay.
Uh-huh.
Oo. Pero yung iba sinasabi dapat sabay-sabay. So, that has to be figured out also.
Okay. So, sa pagkakataon pong ito, marami na pong mga usapin hinggil sa pagbabago o pag-amenda ng Constitution, but so far, none has succeeded. Do you think the next president should focus, or if there is a need to amend the Constitution, that should be one of the priorities of the next president?
Whatever it is, if the next president will do that, he has to do it, he or she has to do it very early on.
Mm-hmm.
We start the process in the first year.
Not on the last.
Kasi
mapagkakamalan na ng mga terms.
That will at least to an extent, to a degree, may suspicious ng tao na ginawa ng lahat ito para mag-extend. At least mababawasan. So that is a possibility.
Do you agree, Mayor?
Yes, I said the next president, by the way, must embrace federalism with passion.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it cannot take off. So ang problema niyan is not really for him to like or dislike unitary or federal, but whether he can hack it and call on the even on the first month of his presidency, call for a constitutional convention, because that body created by law or by proclamation will be representative of the people, because we elect the delegates who will start to amend the constitution.
So it's not Congress who will do the amendment.
And then kasi yung Congress nandiyan na yan. And I said many do not really due respect to the Senate or trust the people there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the one thing that really fearing is that there might also be extension again of terms.
And also para
which is taboo to almost everybody.
And also para na rin sa inyo, Senator, not to be distracted from your work as legislators, not to do the amendment, better to give it to a different independent body.
I agree. There are three methods. Tatlo ang sinasabi by the voting population manifesting, mm-hmm. making a manifesto and signatures. Then there is the Constituent Assembly, which is the Houses of Congress, and then there is a Constitutional Convention.
Mm-hmm.
The Constitutional Convention is probably the most representative because elected ang CONCON delegates,
mm-hmm.
and so at least. Pwedeng makampanya, pwede nang sabihin kung ano yung plano nilang gawin pag sila'y nakaupo bilang delegado sa Constitutional Convention, maliwanag sa tao kung ano yung binuboto nila.
Okay.
Maliwanag kung ano what to expect from their delegate.
Okay. So, Senator, siguro curious din ang ibang mga nakikinig at nanonood sa atin ngayon, ano ba ang inyong mga political plans for 2016?
Wala, sumusunod lang ang uwi. Mayor Duterte, he is my mentor when it comes to politics. At siya ako'y tigahanga ng...
Hindi ko pa may malaman dito kung ako ang presidente o siya, tapos ako.
So, well, that is...
We will leave it to the commentators to speculate, but...
Okay ba ang tandem kung kayong dalawa?
To be president is a matter of destiny.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the vice president. Alam mo bakit?
Bakit?
Isa lang kasi yan eh. Senator masabi mo pa by quirk of fate.
Mm-hmm.
That's a quirk, that's an idiom by accident, quirk of fate. But itong presidency, one-on-one kaya. So whoever reaches that throne there must be the chosen one of God.
So if ever it's possible, the two of you can make it happen.
As Vice President or Selang, tapos it could be Ping, it could be...
Maraming pang nalilitaw dyan. Maaga pa. Unusual itong political cycle natin ngayon. Dahil usually by this time, maliwanag na kung sino yung mga malakas, kanina mga partido ang naka-alyado. Say ngayon, it's very fluid
ang sitwasyon.
Ganun din ang assessment ko, very fluid. So.
But you're very much open to the possibility of running for higher positions in 2016.
I always follow my father's advice. His advice is very simple, keep your options open.
Ayun.
So that's what I'm doing.
So, posible nga.
Well, it is politics. In politics, never say never. I think the mayor will agree with
my father. Forgot to give me the advice, so I'll just end up the advice.
It's good advice, Mayor. It has served me well.
Okay, so we're running out of time. Can we have your parting words?
Yes, I'll give it to you.
Thank you very much for this opportunity. I'm very happy to have been given this chance to be part of this discussion. At marami pa na siguro tayong pag-uusapan, and I'm glad that these national issues were some that we were able to ventilate today. It is very interesting always for me, having come from local government myself, to hear a local executive and what their opinions are on national issues. Mm-hmm. And again, as always, today I learned very many things from our good mayor.
Thank you so much, Mr. Senator, for being part of our show today.